Good morning, everybody. Today we are going to discuss about the application layer. This is the when you take total network hierarchy, that structure, layer structure. Application layer is the top layer. Within that application layer, you have one system that is called DNS. We say domain name system. So why do you need this DNS? What is the importance of this DNS? So whenever you want to search any site through World Wide Web, if you want to search any site, generally human beings, they are familiar with names rather than numbers. So that is the reason most of the time users specifies the name of that World Wide Web or whatever the site you are interested to see that one. Suppose in this case, this person is interested to search cnn.com. So when you type this cnn.com at client location, but basically internet environment can understand IP address, basically is looking for this server. This server is identified with an IP address 12.3.4.15. But actually, he typed cnn.com. So then who will provide this IP address for him? So that is the reason at application layer, we have domain name system. Here we have a domain name server within this. So once you type this one, this will be connected to domain name system, their domain name server, mapping this name with IP address. That IP address is given to this client. Once if you get this IP address, then you are going to establish connection with this server. So ultimately he is interested to contact this server. He has no idea about the IP address of this server. That is the reason he is contacting domain name server here. So that domain name server mapping the name with an IP address. So that is the basic function of the domain name system. So this is the understanding of DNS. Now we will see the details. So basically the domain name system, basically we have some space there. We say DNS namespace. So there we are mapping your name with an IP address. So basically you have records at the DNS server. Once you type that particular name, DNS server is giving reply of IP address. So this process technically what you call is the resolver. So application program calls a library processor called the resolver. So this operation we say technically resolver. So resolver is giving name to the DNS server. DNS server in turn is giving IP address for you. So this is the basic platform. Every time we need this operation. So whenever you need this type of operation, generally we work with UDP. Why? Because this is the request and you are getting a reply. That's all, simple service. So we are using UDP, user datagram protocol, connectionless service. Conceptually, the internet is divided into so many domains. So if you see the DNS namespace, so one is generic, another one is countries wise. Like that you can work out a division of this domain name space based on generic criteria following with some hierarchy, or country wise also you can do. Suppose dot in we use. So you can work out with the country wise also. Suppose generic case we follow some hierarchy. Suppose you take education domain, here it is the Washington, it is containing CS as well as ENG, like that there once again robot is there. So this is the hierarchy you are following. Like this you are following COM, Cisco, engineering. Like that we maintain some hierarchy, like that you have government sites. Government sites are beginning with GOE. Like that you have a structure. So this is the what you call is the domain namespace. Even you can work out with the zones also, you can divide into zones. So this is one zone, this is another zone, like that you can work out with the zone wise also. Basically we follow this type of hierarchy when you want to search the things. So basically what is happening at the domain name server? Domain name server is giving reply to the client, that is the containing five elements. One is domain name. It tells the domain to which the record applies, that is the domain name. Second field, time to live. So what is that record, how that record you can maintain, how stable the record is. Suppose here we have mentioned high stable record containing 86,400 thing. So this is the time to live. If you generate a record, how much time that record is available, after that that record is not valid. So that is the time to live. Then we say class, it is IN for the internet information and codes for non-internet information. So what type of class it belongs to, whether it is IN or some other code, you can mention here. It indicates the what type of class that one. And type indicates what type of record that is. Next value, this field can be a number, a domain name or an ASCII string. So these are all the things you will get a reply. So basically our interest, when you take this type of reply, that is the domain name, time to live, class, type, value, these are all the details. But our main interest is their type. If you see this type, so IP version 4 address of a host, here if it is IP address 4, you will get that 32 bit integer here. Or if it is IP version 6, then it is represented at type 4S. So you will get IP version 6, 128 bit value here. So this is the code indicates type here. That value here, for this case it is 32 bit, for this case IP version 6 case it is 128, that value will be here 128 bit. So this is the meaning of type and value. So type and value plays a vital role. Majorly we are looking for this type and value. So present, suppose you are all working with IP version 4, then your type is A. Your value is whatever, maybe the 32-bit integer which you are looking will be available here. So this total, this five tuple will be communicated to the client from the domain name server. So this is the understanding of how DNS will work. Now suppose if you take an example, how resolves the things. how many steps involved? It depends upon what you are looking. So you are looking a robot.cs.washington.edu, then you are giving query. Once you give query, that is immediately connected to your local DNS server. This is your local DNS server. In turn, is contacting root server. In this, education is the root. So you are communicating with the first root server. When you give this query to the root server, then it identifies what is the name, education name server, that is the Washington. So you are in turn, once again you are contacting this education name server. So in the first step, whenever query is given to the DNS, this in turn you are connecting to root server. Root server is giving the name of that server. Then you are connecting to this Washington related this one name server. So you will get that particular name washington.edu, and it is given to the this which thing you are looking. This is the what you call CS. You have mentioned CS. So that is the thing you are getting from this name server. That is the UW name server. You are getting this CS. Finally, based on this, you are contacting UWCS server. Then it is giving robot CS Washington EDU. So finally, this is resolved in this way, and you are working with this local server. These are all hidden as per the user point of view. You cannot see all these things. Finally, what you get, your interest is to get some IP address where you are interested to work out with the particular server. So whenever you get like that IP address, then you are going to connect to the final server, whatever the thing you are looking. So basically, this is the common understanding of DNS. DNS basically identifies the IP address which you are looking. So automatically you are connecting to that server, particular server. So for further understanding, you can refer these references. And thank you for your attention.